think in the old culture, the savoir-faire is more important than the creativity. It is really to validate, to give to the brand a special image which is missing when haute couture doesn't exist. And I think it's a fact that haute couture, the label, the institution, gives the brand a different nature.
Is haute couture fashion or art, or is a little bit of both?
Well, it has been fashion, it must be art. It's a savoir-faire. Because if it can be in ready-to-wear, why should it be at the same time handmade? So it can exist, but really the savoir-faire is central. And I think France has this capacity to study, look after, and really supports young designers through this institution.
Didier, what is the process for someone to become a member of the Haute Couture calendar?
Well, to have the right to the appellation, which is a protected appellation, as you know, you have to be sponsored, parrainé, mm-hmm. should say, by a member and be elected by the couturiers.
Didi, can you tell me a little bit about the role of the web for fashion? It's really changed the whole dynamic of haute couture and ready-to-wear.
Well, as you know, there are new systems which allow the designers to sell by internet. And it's really interesting to see that there is a clientele for young designers having two or three pieces to sell, and they sell. And ModWalk is a good example from it. It's new and it's in to function.
Didier, what is the future of haute couture?
Well, haute couture is supposed to die since 1925. You'd be surprised to have extraordinary articles crying on the end of the artisanate. And as you see, it's still existing and you are still interested. And when you speak with some brands, they will never consider 1 minute to stop the couture. So for me, couture will last forever. But when you see that the major couture houses are the biggest exporters and manufacturers in ready-to-wear, then you wonder why it should stop.